Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everybody. Welcome back to my channel. As you can tell, this is so different. I look like a bum or a ghetto hoop star. I don't know what I look like, but I just felt like kind of talking while I get ready for work.
Okay, side note. My scarf that I wear for work was really dirty, so I washed it, and then I turned the heat on in the room, so it's getting hot. I'm gonna shut the door and see. So now I have a back mirror. I didn't know it had that. Cool. Okay.
As you can see, like, my face is, like, different colors. Like, it's, like, super light, dark, 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 light. It's just from, of course, waxing and plucking. Hotel has one of these mirrors that, like, has a super zoom on this side and like a regular zoom on that side. I do that. Otherwise, I carry around like my own mirror. It cracked on this side. 3 years ago, Valentine's Day, I met a guy on Tinder and he wasn't doing nothing. I wasn't doing nothing. So he was like, let's go out. So we had been talking for about a couple of weeks or whatever, you know, like messaging back and forth. So this would be actually the first time him seeing me in person. Cause I know it's gonna be dark and he said we're gonna go out and meet some of his friends, blah, blah. So I knew it was gonna be a dark area, so I didn't really think I had to. I thought, you know, it's gonna be real quick, so he's not like I'm gonna be up under him. He's just... Hello?
Hello, this is not a sales call, but...
We went to meet his friends bowling. And then we went to like a reggae club and it was so much fun. Like I had so much fun or whatever. The next day, I'm like, you know, so what did you think? That looked like my pictures? And he was like, yeah, dot, dot, dot. You didn't want to wax before you left home? What did he just say? You know, instantly getting defensive. So how dare he? Talking about, you know, why didn't I want to wax first or whatever, whatever. So, went on another date. We're sitting at dinner and it's like one of those places where it's like dark around and they give you one light right here. And one dude was like, what's that? And he touched me. He was like, yeah, what is that? So, instantly, I'm about to get my phone out to get my Uber because this is about to end. So, he was like, you know, I'm just wondering, you know, like, why didn't you kind of shave that? Like, you need my razor? What do you mean, do I need your razor? Like, what are you trying to say? No, I'm just kidding. I just never dated a hairy woman. I ain't never seen a hairy woman for real, you know, come out, whatever. So, 2 days that were at nighttime, and I didn't really do my detailed waxing, plucking, looking like a newborn baby in the face.
And of course, I always ask, you know, like, what are we doing? I will not go with you if you say we're gonna just chill, because I don't know what that means, where we're gonna go, how the lighting's gonna be, what type of hair is gonna pop out that you're gonna see that I didn't get.
I can stand in mirrors for hours and get every hair and just pluck, 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 thinking that, you know, I'm good, and really I'm not. Like, I miss three connect the dots right here. LA Girl Pro Concealer has really like helped with my two different, okay, with my many colors on my face, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so if I was on a date with a guy, let's say it's at lunch, Panera Bread or Starbucks, and that guy, you know, it's bright and he wanna sit by the window. Instantly, I wanna be like this. On a date and he's sitting like right there. So you have a good view of all of this. Like, no, I wanna be face to face so you can get to know me. But for the first time, I wanna look at you. I don't do that side stuff at the movies and stuff, and you're a full view of this. Like, me being bald head, I don't have any hair to, you know, cover. I haven't worn a wig or a weave in almost 4 months. It's really my sideburns to necks that I'm very cautious about. I'm talking to somebody, and I can see them looking, you know, at not at me. So I'm like, what are you looking at? But you just kind of got to go with the flow and explain to people. But then again, it's something I got to live with. Like, I didn't ask God, can I be black? Can I be a female? Can I have PCOS? Can I have hair tourism that gets out of control, that some days it just makes me want to scream and wear a hat on my head? Just to take away from it, Because there are some days that I really don't feel like putting on so much makeup to cover everything, and it's makeup mainly for work. And I feel like if you are dating a guy, let's say you met on Tinder, because you have a life where you can't always go on a date every Friday after you get off at 5. You meet somebody online, of course, I'm not gonna take a picture and it'd be like this. Like, but then again, I'm not catfishing nobody. But if you feel comfortable with him that he is not gonna judge you, or he's not going to run away or be like, you know, can you wax that or pluck that? Or joke like, I can grow more hair than you. Stuff like that to me is not funny, because like, as a woman, I am very strong and independent, but at the same time, you know, my little feelings can kind of get hurt, and I can feel like, you know, something where you don't always want to have to be on the defense. Like, it would just feel really good to date somebody and you don't have to have your guard up about, you know, what can they see, because it's something that you can't help, like, you know, like birthmarks and stuff. I mean, you can't help how it makes you, you know, stand out, or how like it makes you look. Something, just be yourself. Like, if he's truly genuinely wants to get to know you, this is a part of you. And I've heard too, like, guys don't mind, you know, a hairy woman. Yes, they do. Over the years, I've kind of just gotten comfortable to talk about it, because at first, I would never dream to make this video. I would never get on here barefaced to show anybody what I have to do every day. But I feel like we're in that day and age where so many people are coming out, you know, how you handle, how you deal with this. Because I feel like, and I've experienced it, stuff that I share here from other people, like, it changes your life. I think I'm going through alone, you meet people who go through the same thing, and it's like, finally, like, I'm not alone.
Like, hi, I'm Shay, I have PCOS and a hairy face.
I mean, don't do that, but at the same time, I mean, I feel like it starts with you. Like, you have to be confident that I am beautiful. I am made in God's image. So there's things you can do to not come off as being so hairy, but at the same time, this is just who I am. Like, this is how I'm made. And I am beautiful. I am sexy. Like, and I believe that there is a man out there for me that is gonna love every strand of hair about me. Like, I will be honest, it's not like, you know, I just got this confidence overnight. I would hate going on dates in the daytime. Why do we have to go? Can we, you know, go to one like after 7 o'clock? You know, how about we go after 10 or something? And it's almost like, I like booty call hours, because I want to talk more about this and be more confident when my nephew, who's 6 years old, says, Auntie Shay, you're a girl. Why do you have hair on your face? And I will be honest, that did kind of hurt my feelings. And I was like, Romy, that's just how God made Auntie Shay. When you educate somebody on something, it brings more awareness to them. I'm not about to live life on eggshells for anybody else, and this is just how I am. I can't change it. So it's like, get the whole package or not. I would say my advice to other women would be, it starts with you. It's irritating when you meet somebody and they're looking like at the bottom of you, or they're looking at your sideburn.
And you're like, can I help you?
Did your mom take you out to stare? Why is it not nice to stare at somebody?
If you want to go swimming, or you want me to wear something sexy, give me at least 3 hours in advance so I can nair my whole body and look like a beautiful Barbie. When I nair my whole body and wax my face, I feel like I should be in Ebony magazine. I feel like the sexiest woman. I am waiting for the man that God's gonna bring into my life. Sorry, my posture is bad. He's gonna love me for me and accept me for who I am. You love somebody, you love everything about them. Even if they do a change to advance to a better them, still you loved who they were. That's what made you fall in love. I have a confidence that attracts people in different ways. And I know and look at myself every single day that I am beautiful. I was created and made in God's image. And my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. So if it has a hair from the crown of my head to the sole of my foot, that's just how it is. That's just how it's gonna be. You are beautiful. You are sexy. You are just beautiful. You have to say it to yourself every day. My favorite is Stevie Wonder. Isn't she lovely? But I love me some me. I do. Dating, go out there, boom, this is me. I mean, you know, if they ask you, you know, tell them if you want to, but don't lie about it. Have a great, wonderful day, evening, night, afternoon, and I will see you guys in another video.